nutrition? Are you exercising? Because if somebody is 45 years old, doesn't mean their testosterone is supposed to be in the toilet. You know, with a lot of my patients, unfortunately, it's, you know, they get up at 4 in the morning, they work hard all day, and they're like, oh, cool, like, I like powerlifting. Like, yeah, man, like, you got a lot of potential. This is incredible. What's your program like? And so I just come in, I just like deadlifts, I pick it up, and like, you know, I like to lift. Okay, you know, maybe you should try a program. And no joke, on Facebook, 2 or 3 weeks later, you know, before you get into that, I'm not going to say that my training was optimal or my nutrition was optimal, but I got the most out of that, more or less, that I could through my training. And then, you know, even like looking at multiply stuff, I was like, okay, before I put burrito in my food, we'd be really foolish not to incorporate that into like actual just regular medicine preventative care.
But my pushback would be you're not having exercise science people coming in to buy your lunch as you do pharmaceutical reps.
I wish, man. I don't know. Healthy diet. I try not to eat too much crap. It's there. I tell patients all the time, too, though. There's no fun. There's no reason to live to 99 if you're not enjoying yourself. So finding that balance of 80% of the time you're pretty healthy. 20% of the time you can do whatever you want.
Well, I want to thank you for coming out.
Yeah.
You know, thank you guys for listening. And when we close the show, we're done. And we just stop. So we're done.
If you want to get a bigger squat.
Okay.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Because you're kind of, instead of 10 squatting for quads, glutes, and so forth, is different than a heavy single. If it's too, I gotta think, if it's too far down, your heel's gonna be off of the somewhat of it to breathe, the flex.
Okay.
I'm gonna make a different adjustment.